Good morning, I'm Clinton Griffiths. Happening right now, tens of thousands of containers are stuck at the ports of Los Angeles and Long Beach in California. Those two West Coast gateways move more than a quarter of all American imports. Take a look at this map, courtesy of marinetraffic.com. All those little green dots represent cargo vessels that are currently anchored at or near the ports. More than 60 ships are lined up to dock with wait times stretching to 3 weeks. The Port of Long Beach is now operating 24 hours a day from Monday to Thursday in an effort to deal with the flood of imports, while major ports in Asia and Europe have operated around the clock for more than a year. Now the head of a major Asia ocean shipping company warns that governments may need to intervene to restore order. In an interview with the Financial Times, the president of Mitsui OSK Lines said the industry had miscalculated how long the disorder from the coronavirus pandemic would last, and experts we spoke with say we could be dealing with issues for several more months.
It's data dependent on what happens with the virus. So if you start to see these continual introductions of new variants, different countries reacting to them differently, in particular, regions of China sort of shutting down when a new variant starts to come into play, or there's an outbreak of an existing variant, that's the kind of thing that will keep this shortage alive. So the sooner we can get out of those short-term disruptions to the supply chain at the manufacturing end, the quicker we can sort of get through and have a more normal supply chain picture. But we're looking at 2022 before we can get into that reality.
It's also costing a lot right now to move product overseas. Global container rates hit an all-time high of more than $11,000 earlier this month. That's after having fallen below $1,500 at the start of the pandemic.